Matter of time until we are struck again, but this time with biological and chemical attacks. The thought is scary, but it's important to hope for the best and prepare for the worst. The First Line Defense Kit allows you to do just that. The First Line of Defense Kit includes Nutri-Immune and Nutri-Defense, providing top biological host defenses against pathogen entry, and provides immune NK killer cell boosting. Also included, the Nanomask Nanoparticular Antiviral Masks with replacement filters, providing supreme viral protection from airborne pathogens. And the First Line of Defense Wipes allows non-toxic viral and bacterial pathogen killing power on all surfaces. The First Line Defense Kit is available now by calling 888-212-8871. That's 888-212-8871. Or order online at NutriMedical.com. That's NutriMedical.com. Your source for the most powerful nutraceuticals and wellness protocols from a doctor you can trust.
May I have everybody's attention, please? I've come with a message of information. 9/11 was an inside job.
Do you like being a puppet, sir? Do you like being a puppet for the New World Order?
How do the American people know that 9/11 was a stage, was it engineered by you, David Rockefeller, the Trilateral Commission, the CFR?
Can you please sit down and shut up?
The day that we stop asking questions is the day that we have allowed the seeds of despotism to grow at our own door.
7 years after the attacks of September 11th, a global awakening has taken place.
An inside job? How dare you?
If you know that there's treason going on, you can be held accountable for treason yourself.
All hell is breaking loose on 6th Avenue.
And if the government has not told the truth, in 5 years we will be here on the 10th anniversary of 9/11.
Truth Rising. Download the film at prisonplanet.tv right now, or get the DVD at infowars.com. It's now time to take the revolution to the next level.
Are you wondering about your retirement portfolio? Are you confident that the financial advisor is experienced enough to combat climbing interest rates, taxes, and inflation? Stop guessing and go to the expert, Robert Chapman of the International Forecaster. When you subscribe to the International Forecaster, you get Robert Chapman's 45 years of experience and concise investment recommendations. Who needs sugar-coated excuses when you can get the cold hard facts and proven investment leads you can't get anywhere else? For a free introductory copy to Robert Chapman's International Forecaster, subscribe now at theinternationalforecaster.com or call 877-479-8178. Experience the difference. When you subscribe, you can email Robert Chapman directly to obtain investment advice tailored just for you. Don't wait another minute. Subscribe today at theinternationalforecaster.com or call 877-479-8178. That's 877-479-8178.
You don't have to be in the military to enjoy military surplus savings. Right now at mainmilitary.com, you'll find savings on the top must-have military supplies. M10 gas masks for $12 or 3 for 30. Gas mask hoods, $4 or 3 for 10. Mask filters, $6 or 3 for 15.
What did he say?
Save big on British chemical suits, only $12. Israeli gas masks, $20. Trigger finger gloves, $5 a pair or $36 a dozen. Snowshoe binding for $8 or $48 a dozen, and so much more. Even hard-to-find surplus items, all at surplus prices. Preparing the whole family has never been so affordable at MaineMilitary.com. MaineMilitary.com, one of the last surviving true surplus stores in the country. Shop now at MAINEMilitary.com or call 877-608-0179. That's 877-608-0179 today.
I saw the photograph. He blew his mind out in a car. He didn't notice that the lights had changed.
All right, we are back, ladies and gentlemen. Going to have our guest with us about 40 after them, and then run through a big news blitz of news I haven't gotten to yet. Still taking your phone calls till the end of the transmission. Mike in Austria was still holding. He had something else he wanted to say. Are you done, Mike? Any other questions or comments?
Yes, I have another comment. Because the world government is telling you what they are doing. You just have to read between the lines. If you look in Western media, they are all under one line. And if you read between the lines, they tell you what they will do. So, and also I would like to advise you, Americans to be a little bit cautious. If you are a freedom fighter, you have to protect yourself, because the New World Order really knows what has lots of new weapons and technologies. And they can kill you if they like.
Well, that's the cost of liberty. No guts, no glory, but you're right. Okay, let's go ahead and take another call. Osborne in Missouri, you're on the air. Or is that Montana?
Hey, good afternoon, gentlemen.
Hi.
Good afternoon.
Yeah, I just had a quick, question. It seems like, I mean, Alex, I know you don't like to talk about this movement being culminated in any kind of, like, armed conflict, and I know I would hate to see it go to that level. I actually watched the movie The Patriot the other day. I know you've spoken about it. And I hear a lot of people talking and identifying with the sentiments of the Founding Fathers and such. And it seemed like the Continental Army, they did have good luck with the British. It seemed like they had comparable weapons, the mortars, the muskets, if you will. Nowadays, we might have a pretty well-armed civilian squad, if you will, but, you know, we don't have Predator drones with Hellfire missiles and Apaches. And like I'm saying, if it gets to that level... I mean, is there even a chance?
All right, let's just stop right there. Number one, the colonial army and the militias had a better long rifle that could shoot further with better accuracy. The British were just trained to aim with their muskets and shoot, you know, in large formations, blasting each other. But they 3, 4, 5, in some battles 10, 11, 12 times the numbers of the rebels. You know, of our ancestors. And it was the willingness to keep fighting, keep resisting, and guerrilla warfare. And remember, the military, many people are on our side. It's a info war. It's a propaganda war. If they're able to roll out their police state through riots that are staged to make it look good in phase one, then they're going to have success. It's the info war, the info war, the info war. I mean, let's get real. If things, you know, got to the physical level, other people just have to have a battle plan in mind. That, you know, well, 6 months into something, you know, those helicopters have to land, or these people have to go to bars at night. I mean, come on. If millions of gun owners actually decide, it'll be like moose hunting season, as Mark Kornke always says, where there's a lottery and only 1 out of 10 people gets a moose license. I mean, if we had the will to actually go up against the military, we would trash them from one end to the other. We're not Iraqis, who historically aren't the best shots in the you know field. I don't want that. I don't have some cojones need to, I can't wait to get a shooting war going. But just like The Patriot, which is based on a composite of true stories and real things that happen, burning folks up in churches, you know, all of it. People, the government's going to kill people's children. They're going to kill the wrong people's children, okay? And then people are just going to go off. And then the feds are going to go into bunker mentality, and the local police, you're not going to see them on the road. This is cowardice. The New World Order's people are cowards. You want to comment on that, Mr. Williams?
Yeah, I mean, I definitely agree with the back end of that about certain people being cowards. There's a lot of those. Here's what I see happening. Number one, I wouldn't advocate any kind of violence. This is an information war. Number two, if something happens, it's going to happen. It's going to be a small regional or localized incident. It's not going to be pretty. There could be casualties. There'll probably be casualties. And then the news of that event will travel. And then depending on how that news travels and the response to that news is going to determine what happens next. And that's the critical point where people of good conscience have to act and the right decisions have to be made, because open conflict with the military or the police is not something I don't think anybody's advocating.
Yeah, we want to have the police on our side. We want to have the military on our side. So when the globalists sample the mindset of their forces, they realize it's not their forces. They're our forces, we the people.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Hi, this is Steve Shank. eFoods does it again. The three-day